Tuko hapa leo tumeamua kwamba tuungane na walimu wa JSS wenzetu nchi mzima to demand for us students the TSC respect orders. Jana TSC litoa statement doing all through for the time it has wasted. Right now what is happening, we had some MPs the other day saying that they approve, they do not approve with the court ruling that internship is illegal. Tunataka tuambie wabunge, tunajua mumekuwa mukiandika watoto wenu, watoto wa marafiki wenu, tumekuwa mkiandika wale watu waliwafanyia campaign. Mkiendelea hivyo, nani ataandika mtoto mwalimu wa maskini? Mnataka tuendelee tukilia Shakahola? Sisi tuko na experience ya more than 7 years. Tuko sahi wakati mtu wa 2016 ana serve as an intern in junior school. Kuna mtu wa 2021, 2022, 2023 mwenye amepata barua ya MP. Jana TSC inasema kwamba the internship program is a government program for practical experience for the teachers. What other experience does TSC want us to have? What experience don't we have, yes, that the 2021 graduates have? We want to ask TSC, yes, to be honest and truthful, to confirm us as early as today. We expect it to give us a statement on how it is rolling out our employment program into PNP terms.
Yes.
Ya pili, wakati sisi tuko tunaitisha haki yetu, ofisi ya TSC kuanzia county director
kabisa,
sub county director,
yes,
CSOs,
yes,
na heads of institutions,
yes,
wamekuwa wakitisha walimu,
yes.
Hao walimu wamepitia machungu sana. Say, these teachers are depressed.
Yeah.
So whatever kind of threats you give them, you are threatening dead souls. They no longer fear threats.
Yeah.
So we are asking that you confirm and compensate us as early as today.
Yeah. Yeah. Power!
Okay. My name's
Yes. CSOs,
yes. Na heads of institutions,
yes.
Wamekuwa wakitisha walimu,
yes.
Hao walimu wamepitia machungu sana,
yes.
These teachers are depressed,
yes.
So whatever kind of threats you give them, you are threatening dead souls. They no longer fear threats,
yes.
So we are asking that you confirm and compensate us as early as today,
yes. Power.
Okay. My names are Zachariah, Nyomboi, Kipsaina. The executive secretary of KUPPET Baringo. I wish to state the following today. And the government must come out clear, and Teacher Service Commission need to be very serious. Number one, I want to tell the government, I want to tell the Teacher Service Commission, don't lie to yourselves. Don't hide. Because there are only three things now. One, the JSS teachers are either in the streets, like how we are now. Number two, they are in their homes. And number three, they are those who are in school and doing nothing. So between the three, which choice will you take? It is either we are idle in the school, we are in the streets, or we are cooking uchi in our villages because there is no money. It is very unfortunate. And I want to tell the Teacher Service Commission, you should not threaten the JSS teachers. Because the statement that I saw yesterday from the Teacher Service Commission is a big joke. We cannot allow our JSS teachers to go to school when they are earning 17,000 shillings. 17,000 shillings in Lokumkum Primary School in Baringo cannot even make to be enough for transport alone.
Yes.
And it's unfortunate that our members of parliament, they are either cowards or psychophants, or just I don't know what the name I can give them. Some of them, many of them are silent, and they know that their schools in Baringo, in all over Kenya, children are not being taught. What are you doing about it? You are very busy going to pass bills in parliament, and yet you have people who are earning 17,000, not even equivalent to sitting allowance in parliament. So government must give Teacher Service Commission the money to employ JSS teachers on permanent. It's not business as usual, unless government is ready to waste a generation. And I want to say today, we are very saddened. We are very demoralized. And in many cases, these JSS teachers have gone through a lot. You find that a member of parliament today is coming with a permanent job. Another one is dishing in funerals. Others are dishing it in homes in their villages. For children who were taught by these JSS teachers in 2015,
yes.
And they are now in permanent, and you are telling us that we are in internship. I want to ask the government, what type of internship is this? You are having a teacher in internship and you are saying that we are trying to train them to be good teachers. And yet you have given a permanent job to somebody who finished last year. Why don't you allow that one to go for internship and put on permanent those who are internship?
Correct.
And we want to ask EACC, if you are serious, if you are not puppet of government, can you investigate Teacher Service Commission,
yeah,
and give us a report how many teachers have been employed in the last 2 years on permanent?
Exactly.
We want to know how many teachers have been employed in permanent. And I want to challenge. I want to challenge Committee for Education. Can you ask for the document that shows how many teachers have been employed on permanent for the last 2 years? And then we shall have something to say. Otherwise, today, we are saying that going forward, from today, going forward, from yesterday, we are going to continue with it. It is either we shall be in the street, it is either we shall be in our homes, or we shall be in school, eating there and relaxing, and doing nothing, not going to class.
Yes.
And one, when you threaten this JSS teacher, do you you expect a TSS teacher to be threatened by 17,000?
No.
17,000 shilling?
No.
And
no.
You are saying that I can sack you? What are you sacking? Whom are you sacking? If the government cannot employ these teachers on permanent, wacha wakae na yukasiao. Wacha wakae na yukasiao. So we are saying, comrades, power!
Power!
Mughul is power!
Power!
Mughul is power!
Power!
Otherwise, I want to say today that the threats we are receiving, even from CSOs, can you stick to your programs in schools? Go to school. If you don't find a teacher in class, go and assist the class and come and tell the government what is happening.
Yes.
Our TSS teachers, our graduates who have spent more than 500,000, cannot earn 17,000. For how long will they recover that money? Unless we are not in business, we must feed our families. We must feed our children. We cannot allow the government to abuse us and to misuse us as cheap labor.
Yes.
Thank you so much.